on you now. Bathroom, nigga with bikini. I'm hoping you say two or three. Agree that indeed you look good. And we came to party, but I don't wanna waste my time. I'll waste your time. I'll waste your time. My life. Oh, thank you, Jesus, for my life. What is up, my girlies? Welcome back to another video with your girl Britt. Y'all see by the title about them, that was the video was about. Happy Sunday, you guys. Happy Sunday. This we in 21 days in this day for the first, still the first year of 2024, you guys. So like I said, happy Sunday. I did not make it to church this morning. I overslept. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. I woke up, it was 11 something. My sister called me at 9:30 something, 9:40. I was tired, I was asleep. But we need to make more excuses for this year. But before we get started, y'all see me doing my face routine this morning, me cleaning up and stuff. I didn't vlog all that, but yeah, that's in this video. I did my hair, y'all. I know I'm looking like I'm about 13, 12 years old, or 17, whatever, y'all. But I'm like, let me see, can I do my hair, y'all? My out of product then dried down, so that's why you're looking all bushy. But at first, it was all curly. It was all cute and stuff and wet, y'all. But the drawstring. The draw of your hair. What's the word for it? I'm trying to, like, But yeah, anyways, y'all see what I mean. We got the candle going right here. We got some water. I'm gonna ask y'all a few questions. You know, cause y'all wanna know whatever. You know, so I'm gonna put out some questions for you guys. Let me see, can y'all see? So I'm gonna put out some questions for you guys. Just 15 questions. I'm gonna go in order. I'm gonna make it fun for y'all. So let's go ahead and get started, y'all. I don't have no wine right now, so. We just gonna go ahead and get started. Before we get started, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe if you're new to my channel. Make sure you turn your notification post on, hit that bell, and come be a part of your girl journey, you know? And come be a part of your girlies. Cause yes, we over here, we gonna be lit. That's about it. So like I said, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and let's get started on this video. Okay, you guys, I am back, you guys. I don't know what happened, but I did a whole video, y'all. A whole 12-minute video. And it's safe. My memory is too full. So, iPhone, y'all need to upgrade y'all memory or, like, space, storage, whatever. But, yeah. So, y'all, I'm about to do some questions about me. Y'all get to know me a little bit. I just got some questions on my phone. I'm asking y'all like 15 questions. We're gonna make it too long, you know? Just about me that I feel like y'all should know about your girl. So, yes, my girlies, we're gonna get to know Britt or whatever. So, yeah, so I was just gonna say, I'm not going order. Okay, number one, it says, How can I express my love more to others? Can I express it in a better way? Of course you can express your love to others. You know, y'all gotta be together. Y'all gotta be in like a committed relationship. You don't gotta be like in a instead of relationship, you don't gotta be in a relate situation with somebody. You know, if you just want to love that person because they're a good friend, because they've been out for you, with you, through everything and stuff like that, it's always good to you have to express your love to others. Now, can you express it in a better way? Of course, you know, you can express it in a way better way. You know, like, for example, say like me and my spot, we talking, you know, and we just like giving each other that sparkly eye type of connection or whatever, and I'm speaking my love to him in the way that I want my father to speak to me, you know, as his daughter, you know, type of love he have for me and stuff like that. So yeah. What else? Number two. It said, am I practicing self-care enough? I can say I am. I can say most definitely I'm practicing self-care, you know, a lot. You know, I feel like I came from here to be where I'm at right now, you know, and where I'm about to be for their life. So, yeah, I feel like I'm practicing so much. Like, that's one thing about staying with people and having your own place or staying with your spa or whatever the case may be. Me and my boyfriend, we give each other that space that we need, you know, like when he got to work for a couple of minutes, like for hours and stuff. This is my time right now. Just, you know, have my self-care, my self-love, my self-respect. Give myself that self-peace that I need, you know, just meditate, all that other stuff, y'all. So, yeah, I practice it real well. So, don't never feel like that you not giving yourself that self-care that you need, because you probably is, you know, you probably just feel like you're just doing it all over women. Okay, number three, they say, what are my most favorite things about myself? My most favorite things about myself is my smile, my sense of humor, my heart, you know, my hair. I love my hair. I love like my natural, you know, look and stuff like that, y'all. Like, yeah. I had a product drawn on my hair, so it's probably like this, y'all. What else I love about myself? I love my self-confidence. When I tell y'all, like, I have so much self-confidence, it's crazy. Like, oh my God, like, I speak so much. Like, I tell myself, Brittany, girl, you doing it. You doing it. Like, you never thought you can do it. You always doubt yourself, but you doing it. And I love that for myself. So, I just love how I'm pushing myself to be better even more, you know, like, challenging myself, you know, always like want to speak highly of myself. So yeah, y'all. What else? Number four. We're on four, y'all. Keep up with the numbers, y'all. It said, where do I want to travel to? My first vacation I'm gonna travel to is Jamaica or Hawaii. Like, I always wanted to travel to Jamaica, you know, just to, you know, feel their culture, you know, the breathe out there, you know, just to get, like, memories, stuff like that. And, yeah. Number five, it says, where would I want to live if I could live anywhere in the world? If I could live anywhere in the world, I would want to live in... I ain't gonna say New York because everybody's saying that it's stank out there. I don't know. I never been to New York, so I don't know how it smells out there. But I know it's beautiful. I know it's expensive, so I ain't gonna say New York. But I would love to live like in, I don't know. I don't know. That's a good question. I don't know. I feel like I've been in Houston all my life. So it's like I'm from Houston. So it's like I don't want to go to Dallas. I don't want to go to San Antonio. I don't want to go to Austin. I want to go somewhere out the country. So I ain't gonna say Dubai. I don't know. That's a good one. That's a good one. I'm gonna come back to that one. I'm gonna let y'all know. Cause that's a good one. Y'all let me know where y'all wanna live at if you have a chance to live anywhere in the world. Okay, number six. It says when I was little, what did I want to be when I grew up? They didn't grow up or grow up. I don't know, y'all, but yeah. When I was little, I always wanted to be a mother, y'all. Like, I used to always love playing with my baby dolls. I remember my grandma bought me and my sister these twin dolls off the Rugrats, Deal and Phil, y'all. If y'all never watched Rugrats growing up, y'all not a really 90s baby. But we used to always play with them dolls. We had multiple dolls. We played school. We played mama. We played like we was in church. Like, y'all, playing church was fun growing up, y'all, fun. We played mama. Playing mama was so fun, y'all, so fun. We played school. School was extra fun, y'all. Like, man, it was so good. But I always want to be a mother, like, because I love helping people. I love to give people my love. I love to love on people. You know, I love to, like, just be in that area, just, like, giving people that unconditional love, like, living on, you know, just, I don't know, y'all, I want to be a mother, so, yeah, but, yeah. Okay, number seven, it says, what is my dream job now? My dream job, I'm gonna keep on claiming it, you guys, is to be a YouTuber. I am a YouTuber, I will be a YouTuber, and y'all wouldn't, they gonna never stop you, girl. But yeah, that's you know, I'm gonna be a YouTuber. Like, I'm gonna be an influencer. I need y'all help right there. You right there. You under there. Like, I need y'all help. Okay, I'll be back. Number nine. Okay, number nine said, "What helps me relax? What helps me relax is like listening to my gospel music. Just talking to God." You know, or either writing in my journal or in my book, you guys. Or just, everybody know. If you know, you know. If you know, you know. Soaking in a tub is my number one go-to to relax my mind, my body, my soul. Just cleanse me out. Like, y'all, I love to soak in a tub. So, if you can't find ways to relax, them are a couple things that I do. You probably never do. So, yeah. Okay, y'all, what's number 10, y'all? It says, what is the meaning of life? And it said, what is my purpose? What is the meaning of life and what is my purpose? The meaning of life is just like being in a moment, you know? Like just waking up, you know, to a new day, a new start, you know? Creating multiple memories, you know, in life, you know. I know life can be stressful, life can be hard, life can be like overwhelming, you know, but just being in a moment, making memories and just waking up every day is like thinking life. My purpose in life is, like I say all the time, to help people. I always want to help people, even though that I know I got a disability. Like, Brittany, girl, you only can do so much. I feel like I could do a lot. Because we just doing it this year. We just doing it, you know? So, I love to help people. Like, I feel like that's my purpose. Like, I love to help people. It just, like, it brings so much. Like, no, y'all, if y'all know, but it brings just so much, like, so much power and love in my heart. You know, if I feel like my heart be just pouring out with love. It's like, how many people just, I be wanting to help and stuff like that. Even though I get like a lot of backlash. I get a lot of, you know, talked about, made fun of still to this day on my other platforms like that, y'all. But sometimes I have to remain humble. When you remain humble, it's for the better. So, yeah, y'all. But, okay, number 11. It said, do I like who I have become in what way? Of course, I ain't gonna say I like it. I love where I'm at in my life. I love who I became. Yeah, I became this strong woman. I became this strong, independent woman. I became this strong, loving woman. I became over everything that I've been through, you know. And I'm just so happy where I'm at, like who I'm becoming, and you know, and stuff like that. I'm facing the better version of myself, you know. I feel like this version of myself is so great, you know. Like God is working on me, and it's like I want people just to see that. Like don't look at me, don't look at my life like, oh, she played with God, wooty woo, this and that. No, it's just like this is the better version of myself, and God working on me. And as long as he's working on me, I'm working on myself. That's all that matters. And it said, in what way? Like everything, you know, it's like the better version of myself is like overcoming things, you know, like having low self-esteem, you know, didn't have that much confidence in myself, you know. And just like always think I'm not pretty enough. You know, I ain't gonna lie, y'all, when I was younger, I used to always wanna like, you know, look like my sisters and them, like when they be in the mirror doing their hair, flat nining every day, you know, putting their makeup or their earring with their whoop. And I used to just like go to school like either braids or just have my hair in a ponytail. But now that this version of myself right now, I can do anything that's possible. Yeah, I put my own lashes on, I did my own hair. Put my own hair in this bun. I'm looking like I'm 17 or 12. Y'all, I'm doing it. That's all that matters, you know? So, yeah. Okay, what else? We're on what? 13, right? Yeah, 13. 13, it said, what's my favorite quote? My favorite quote is, girl, get up. You're doing it. That's my favorite quote. Girl, get up. You're doing it. And I know I'm doing it. So, yeah. Okay, what else? Number is, who do I look up to? I look up to all my sisters. I look up to my mother and my grandmother. You know, I look up to all the women that's in my life that's, you know, that's present, you know. They're teaching me, they're learning me. Even with my other two sisters that have kids, you know, they teach me, like, one day if I do be able to have kids or, you know, if it was a kid or whatever the case may be, I know how I do it because I saw them do it. So, you know, I saw them, you know, take care of their kids, this and that. So, yeah, I look up to the women in my life. And most of all, I look up to God. Like, God teaching me, God learning me, God showing me, you know. So, yeah. What else? Number, almost done. Number six, it says, where are some of my most favorite pieces of advice? What are some of my most favorite pieces of advice? My most important favorite pieces of advice to give people is to never give up, you know. Let me see. The advice is just like never give up, you know, keep going. That's the main advice I would give somebody. Just be you, never stress, you know, like look your best every day and stuff like that. So you got this. That's the advice I would give somebody. Just like you got this, keep going, you know, always look your best, never stress, and just, yeah, live in the moment. Number, what is the meat? Okay, I said that already. It said, what am I afraid of? How can I work on these fears? What I'm afraid of and how can I work on these fears? Everybody that knows me. And I'm not going to just like, this is like just the thing I'm just like, But my, what I'm scared of, like, being on this earth alone, you know? And just like not having nobody there, you know, to give me the comfort, like somewhere way to go, you know. So yeah, but what else? Let me see what it said. Oh, it's saying how I work on these fears. I pray a lot, but I pray. I ask God, don't let me, You know, don't let these fears attack my mind on my soul. Don't let it attack my mind on my soul and my heart. Like don't let me think that, oh, I can't do nothing because I'm too fearless or I this and that. Like, I want to be able to, like, come over every fear that I have so I can continue to stay focused. So, yeah. Number 17 said, what is my most favorite thing about life right now? My most favorite thing about life right now is that we made it. We in 2024. I remember they said that we were going to make it 2020. You know, COVID had hit. We lost a lot of loved ones. But we made it, you guys, by the grace of God, 2024. Yeah, I'm happy about life right now. I'm ready to see where God is about to take me on his journey, you know. So, yeah. Okay, we on my questions. We on 18. It says, what does family mean to me? Family means everything. A family that prays together stays together. Is my family perfect? No, we're not perfect. We fight. We fuss. We don't speak to each other in months. But when it comes down for us coming out together and standing up, we'll do that. So I think every family is not just that golden perfect family. But God working on my family. But the meaning of family is, you know, making memories, loving on your loved one, you know, teaching teaching our kids how you're supposed to be in life, you know, and so they can teach their kids, the next generation, or whatever, you know. So I feel like family means just to, like, stick together no matter what the situation is, stick together as a family. And let's hold each other down. You know, I pray every night for my family. I pray that we all get together and stand together as one. Because my grandmother is all we have. Like, I'm just saying it. I'm just being real. So, yeah. It says, what am I passionate about? Cooking. I love to cook. I feel like that's my passionate. I love to, like I told you guys, throw out new challenges for myself. But like I was saying, y'all, I love to cook. I love to cook, y'all. Like, that's my passionate. I feel like I want my own restaurant, you know. I want my own restaurant, so yeah. The last one, let me find a good one for y'all. A good one. Okay, this is a good one to leave off on. Number 20. It says, what is something I believe I need to work on about myself? Stop being so nice. I need to work on, like, how to, I ain't gonna say treat people how they treat me, because I don't want to treat nobody how they treat me. I want to treat everybody with love, kindness, with just being there if I could, you know? But I just need to work on, like, my niceness. Like, I need to stop being so nice. Like, right? It's not a crime to, like, stop being nice, right? Because I need to know. Because I don't want to feel like they, I'm doing, like, girl, you like, you supposed to be nice, like, you know? But I feel like, yeah, I just never got me being, like, my niceness. I'm so nice. I'm so sweethead. I'm so just, yeah. But okay, you guys. Okay, girlies, this would end the vlog for today, you guys. Hope everybody enjoyed it. Sit and knowing about your girl with Brit. I hope everybody enjoyed it. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe if you're new to my channel. Make sure you turn your notification post on. Y'all, please interact with me, y'all. If anybody want me to open a P.O. box, please let me know down below in the comments and I will do that so I can start. If y'all want to send me things, if y'all want me to promote y'all business, y'all clothing line, whatever the case may be, I'm up to it. Senate and arbitrator. We're gonna be in motion. We in motion all this year. What else? You know, for my girlies tonight, I want to say to you guys, I want to say to you girlies, keep going. You got this. Don't give up. Don't feel like everything is too hard to keep. It's not. Keep going. Stay blessed. Continue to pray. And yeah. And I'm out.